That's Shawn Michaels. He thinks he's pretty. I'm pretty. I ever get him in the ring, I'll make him look pretty. Pretty silly. Hey, those guys are pretty tough athletes. But that Yokozuna, fat. Too fat. Fat chance he's gonna take me in the ring. I'll show him.
Hey, I don't know. Was there something I said?
Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to Wrestling Challenge on Gorilla Monsoon, along with Stan Lane. And talk about tough guys. There'll be plenty of tough guys in Madison Square Garden for WrestleMania 10 and 10 big matches. How more fitting can you get than that? And one of the paramount ones, of course, the big sibling rivalry between Bret the Hitman Hart and Brother Owen.
Oh, yes, you are right, Big Gorilla. 10 years in the making, WrestleMania 10. And speaking of something that was years in the making, Owen Hart tells me this hatred, this rivalry, has been a lifetime in the making. That's why he tells me he's going to end Bret Hart's career once and for all at WrestleMania 10. But I, for one, think Owen is being a spoiled brat about this whole thing.
Well, spoiled brat or not, he's showed us plenty here in the past several weeks, just going through all kinds of tough competition, but he's still got to meet the excellence of execution. We've got a tremendous lineup. Just listen to this.
Oh, what a lineup we have this week, Gorilla. We're starting things off the man from Music City, Old Double J.
Herman Long Sparky is getting ready to rev it up.
And then the man who makes the earth move, the Earthquake, is here.
Tag team action with the Head Shrinkers, and a special feature on WWF Champion Yokozuna. Here we go. Take a look, jam-packed here this week for Wrestling Challenge. And why not?
Boy, the countdown continues. Gorilla, are you excited or what? We are just 2 weeks away from the granddaddy of all pay-per-views.
Am I ever? This will go down in the annals of the World Wrestling Federation as the greatest wrestling extravaganza of all time. And how about this, Dan? Coming up very shortly, the march to WrestleMania 10. In fact, it is next weekend. Some of the feature matches, Yokozuna in a non-title against the Native American Tatanka, and Lex taking on Ludwig Borga, and the Hitman against the big guy from Kona Thrash.
Oh, unbelievable king of primates that you are. I tell you what, it's so big, it's going to be unbelievable. And you know what I'm looking forward to? I've already got my brand new outfit for the Fan Fest weekend.
I hope it doesn't look like that one.
Not a chance, baby.
Fan Fest is indeed hot prior to WrestleMania. All kinds of great things for the fans to do and be a part of the WWF.
And Old Double J, Jeff Jarrett, Nashville, Tennessee's favorite son, is in WrestleMania.
Boy, he certainly is part of that big 10-man tag team matchup. And I'll tell you what, Double J never stuck for an answer when you ask him a question. If you want to know what's on his mind, ask it.
Oh, WrestleMania 10, the greatest wrestling event in the world today. I can see it now. Double J's name in lights. Double J, that's J-E-double-F. J-A-double-R-E-double-T, that's Double J now. The greatest wrestler in the world today.
Well, there are some rumors floating around, Stan, that possibly Double J is going to sing at the Fan Fest.
Well, if he does sing, it'll certainly be the first time. He's been here a couple of months now, and he hasn't sung one note yet, Gorilla.
Well, he certainly hasn't. I don't think he can sing at all.
Well, I know who can sing. That's Little Richard, Lucille, Good Golly, Miss Molly, and Tutti Frutti.
Can he ever? And he'll be kicking things off at WrestleMania 10 with America the Beautiful, as Double J is really unloading here on this youngster. That's a choke, Brett.
Well, it certainly is. Mike Moraldo in all kinds of pain right here. Speaking of singing, what about Donnie Wahlberg from NKOTB? He'll be singing too, maybe. Well, we don't know that. He's a guest ring announcer, but who knows? He may sing.
How about Jenny Garth? What's she going to do? Just look good, right?
Well, she can sing to me anytime. I tell you, Moraldo's getting stomped like a circus monkey.
Look out, Irish whip in. Backdrop, all nice elevation.
Double J.
Says you're going down. He's already down, but he's not out yet. Wow, he wouldn't have hit my grandmother with that right hand. Look out.
Oh, drove him down.
Gorilla. It's all over but the show.
It's got to be done. It's a done deal for Double J, Jeff Jarrett.
Double J on his way to the big one. WrestleMania 10, March 20th, Madison Square Garden. The greatest wrestling extravaganza of all time. And he's part of it. Part of that big 10-man tag team matchup.
10-man tag, WrestleMania 10. 10 years in the making. I tell you what, he's looking sharp. Shoots Mike Morrell in for the ride. And nice high drop kick. And then clutches him and drives him down that modified DDT. Old Double J victorious.
Well, standing by right now, another one of our colleagues, His Lordship, with a special report.
Hello, everyone. This week's special report is brought to you by the official WWF merchandise catalog, featuring a superb line of WrestleMania 10 t-shirts, hats, and jackets. The catalog can be found in all WWF magazines and programs, which are available at newsstands everywhere. As we rapidly approach March 20th and WrestleMania 10, there is an air of exciting anticipation, particularly focusing on Bret Hart going against his own brother, Owen. For years, people have referred to the Rocket Owen as the Hitman's shadow. Well, do you know what? He is. Because recently, he has never once missed an opportunity to observe up close every fleeting moment of Bret's matches. But rest assured, what he has seen does not intimidate him one iota. Au contraire, my friends. One could say that Owen is sizing Bret up for his sacrificial offering at WrestleMania 10. Let me take you back to last week, WWF Superstars, where Bret Hart collided with Adam Bomb. Whilst everybody watched this explosive match with enormous interest, the Rocket was observing for a very different reason.
To the Hitman Bret Hart. Then again, take nothing away from the aggressiveness of Adam Bomb. And then again, think about the emotional scars that Bret Hart has suffered as a result of his brother's actions. Look at that. Owen Hart looking on. Owen Hart will face his brother at WrestleMania.
You know, Bret the Hitman has fought his way for 9 long years to every single title in the WWF, but this may be his greatest challenge of all, facing his own kid brother.
Oh, what devastating clothesline.
Registered an impressive victory here, but was Owen also a victor? His smile as he walked away told me he had seen something, a weakness he could exploit at WrestleMania 10, as he confided to me later that day. This weekend, the redoubtable Rocket appeared on that despicable little toad, Paul Bearer's funeral parlor.
Known as the Rocket! just a coin toss. It seems that he's lost a brother.
Well, you know what? That's right, Brett. You may have lost the coin toss, and Lex Luger, you may think that you're the big winner because you won the coin toss. But I'm the real winner. I'm the one that won because I get you at WrestleMania 10, Brett. And I've been waiting for this for oh so long.
But why? I can't understand why you would stand in Brett's way of becoming two-time WWF champion.
You want to know why I haven't been standing in your way, Brett? You've been standing in my way all my life, Brett. That's all I ever heard about is what you've done, Brett. Well, I'll tell you something. You went out and you won the World Championship. You won the WWF Tag Belt. You won the Intercontinental Belt. You've been Wrestling Superstar of the Year. But tell me this. What does that make me when I beat you at WrestleMania 10? Because that is what I'm going to do to you.
But everyone seen you standing in the back watching Brett's matches. Why are you doing that?
That's right. I've been standing in the back watching your matches. I don't need to learn anything. I know it all. But I've been watching just to let you know, Brett, that I'm watching every move you make.
But your dear mother and father, what do they think about the situation?
Look at what is with you people. Why do you worry about my mother and father? Don't worry about them. You worry about me. I don't know why all you people think that I've done something wrong. You're worried about poor Brett. What about me?
But you kicked Brett while he was down.
That's right. I kicked him when he was down. I kicked him when he was down. And it felt good. It felt great. I loved it. But the only thing that I'm going to do different at WrestleMania 10 is I'm going to kick him, and I'm going to kick him, and I'm going to kick him again. And Bret Hart, when I'm done with you, you won't be looking towards any world title match because you're not going to be able to get through me, brother.
I don't know about all of that. It could be the hitman Bret Hart who's doing the kicking Owen Hart's butt.
And you remember that, Bret.
It was an age of tradition and privilege when eminence was a birthright and passion a sin. Now, from the director of A View from the Shore comes a motion picture of rare significance.
Naked Gun 33 and a third, The Final Insult, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, March 18th at theaters everywhere.
The arena is literally rumbling here, and so is our platform. Gorilla Monsoon along with Stan Lane as we watch the mammoth earthquake. Holy mackerel.
Boy, nobody shakes up the World Wrestling Federation quite like the Quake. He's making his triumphant return, and he's looking good. He's bigger than ever, Gorilla.
Boy, he certainly is. 460-something pounds will be facing Iron Mike here, but at the big one, March 20th, Madison Square Garden, WrestleMania 10, he'll be looking at a tough customer in the form of Adam Bomb.
Well, I don't know if Three Mile Island has ever experienced an earthquake, but it might do it at WrestleMania 10, March the 20th.
Take a look. Iron Mike is going for the full
Can't
Nelson.
Can't quite make the reach, Iron. Boy, he is huge. The girth on this man is unbelievable.
And moves with tremendous agility when he has to. Side headlock here by Iron Mike. Trying to gain a little control in this matchup. Boy, he bellows, doesn't he, Stan?
He's like a moose. Boy, look at the strength of the Quake. Just hoists it up 290 pounds like it was nothing.
Got a handful of hair. Wanted to give him a negative attitude. Referee right there. I don't think Quake will do it.
No, I think he's just teasing the crowd and threatening Iron Mike Sharp.
You bought a little bit of time, Mike. For how long? That remains to be seen.
Earthquake rubbing the eye that was thumbed earlier. Real quick, little thumb to get the Quake stopped for that headlock.
No, I don't care how big you are. You catch a finger in the eye, that stops you. Whoa, he's
almost
riled up.
Almost fell out of my chair.
He's riled up. Irish whip by the big guy. Iron Mike hard into the corner. Quake moves right in with an avalanche.
Well, that'll flatten out your day in a heartbeat.
Make life visible for you.
Well, the crowd loves the Quake, don't they?
Boy, they certainly do. What a following he's got here in the World Wrestling Federation. Look at this.
Wow, the impact, the reverberation. What a Richter scale.
Came right down on the sternum as he continues to go to work here on Iron Mike. And we talked about that big matchup coming up at WrestleMania 10. And we have Bomb standing by.
Earthquake, WrestleMania is almost here. And my advice to you is to find the nearest bomb shelter, because nuclear devastation will be all over you at WrestleMania 10.
Confident and ready indeed. Every match at WrestleMania 10, a blockbuster, a knockout. What a tremendous event this is going to be.
Boy, and you know Harvey Whippleman will have the atom bomb ready for the Quake. This could be Quake's biggest challenge to date at WrestleMania 10.
Boy, he says this is it.
Here this comes. Is it, all right.
Oh, boy.
Wow, the entire building rocking. Here comes the Quake.
Off one rope, off the other.
Sharp, and it's done.
Take a good look at him, Bomb. This is what you're going to be facing at WrestleMania 10. The awesome power, agility, and strength of the big guy, Earthquake. Holy mackerel, what a matchup.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
I always like to keep my favorite snack handy. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah!
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Face to Face. I'm Stan Lane, and yesterday on WWF Superstars, I told you some of the things you can see and do at the WWF Fan Festival. But there's a whole lot more. You can get your photo taken and put on the cover of a WWF magazine. Get autographs from several World Wrestling Federation superstars like Bret the Hitman Hart, Macho Man Randy Savage, the Intercontinental Champion Razor Ramon, and even Lex Luger, the man made in the USA. Plus, you can participate in the WrestleMania 10 hotline and hear live ringside interviews with WWF superstars. Bring your whole family down to the WWF Fan Festival, and don't forget to bring your camera. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Remember to listen to WPLJ 95.5 FM for more information on the Fan Festival, and look in next weekend's Daily News for the special WrestleMania 10 section and poster. You can get your tickets at the box office, all Ticketmaster locations, or call 212-307-7171. Don't forget, discount coupons for the Fans Festival are available at all PC Richards and Sons stores. One of the matches that's going to be there is brother against brother, the Rocket Owen Hart and Bret the Hitman Hart. I talked to Owen earlier and asked him, has it been difficult to prepare for WrestleMania 10, considering the heartbreak that this has caused your family?
You know, Stan, I'm getting sick and tired of hearing about all the heartache of my family. I've had it up to here. They all worry about themselves. They don't worry about me. Well, Brett, you got them all brainwashed, don't you? You got them all thinking that you're some big hero, some good guy. Well, Brett, all I know is what you've done to me all my life. You held me down all my life, Brett, because you're too damn selfish. Deep down inside, you know I'm better than you, Brett. I can beat you. I'm a better athlete than you, Brett. I was better in school. But you've cast this shadow on me. You've tried to keep me down because you're scared, Brett. Deep down inside in your heart, you're scared. You know I'm better than you. And come WrestleMania 10, Brett, I'm coming at you like a freight train, and I'm not stopping. I'm going to beat you, Brett, at WrestleMania 10, brother.
Wow, what a blood feud that's going to be. I talked to the Hitman earlier, and I also asked him, how's it going to feel to look across the ring and see your own flesh and blood ready to do battle with you?
Well, it's something that I've started to get used to. You know, Owen, this is your idea. You're the one that wanted to do this. You're the one that wanted to face me. You know, you talk about when we grew up as kids about you were a better football player and you were a better amateur wrestler. Well, I guess it's all come to a big head. You know, I'm willing to look at this thing only one way. This is just another match. Unfortunately for me, I got family ties involved, and I just got to throw that all out the window, because Owen, you are just another opponent. And if you want to wrestle with me, fine, let's wrestle. We'll wrestle right by the rules, but I don't imagine it's going to quite go like that. And if you want to fight fire with fire, that's fine with me, because the Hitman is going to be the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be.
Fans, don't forget, be a part of the first ever WWF Fan Festival, Friday, March the 18th through Sunday, March the 20th. You gotta be there.
Beat us.
That's the song that Tony Roy and Scott Tenner are probably singing to themselves right now, because look who's on the way to the ring. They're bad. They're dangerous. They're unpredictable. The Head Shrinkers.
Well, Ray Charles was one of the many celebrities at WrestleMania 2, but I tell you what, celebrities really jumping on the bandwagon here for WrestleMania 10.
What did he say?
He said this match is going to be over in a hurry because the bunch is warming up.
Let me just check my Samoan to English translation guide here. And yeah, you're correct. That's exactly what he said.
Talk about dangerous, guys. This pair right here, along with their... Oh, there's Nikolai.
Who's that? And he's wearing the same suit he had on Valentine's.
Nikolai Volkov.
That suit straight off the rack from Goodwill Industries.
One of the many superstars in attendance here. Former superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation. Still looks to be in great shape.
Yeah, still uglier than ever, too. Oh, the bongos are beating. The jungle music.
We know. Head Shrinkers, of course, are part of that big 10-man matchup at WrestleMania 10, being joined by Double J and Irwin and the model Rick Martel.
What a compilation of superstar talent that is.
And on the other side, what a powerhouse, smoking guns, Native American Tatanka, the Kid and Sparky.
Wow. Okay, get ready to get going here as soon as they do their ritual here. We've seen this before.
Get off all that paraphernalia.
I hope Tony Roy and Scott Tenner are prepared, because we know what usually happens following this ritual. They go off. They're all over you.
I don't think that these two youngsters can do enough to prepare for this team. They are devastating. Just a question of time in my book until they become WWF Tag Champions.
Wow. Devastation Incorporated right there.
Double swing shot in. Look out. Oh, look at that elevation.
Wow, the hang time of a hot air balloon.
Wow. That was like a bungee jump without the cord.
He was up in the stratosphere.
Well, guys, in that 10-man, that's what you've got to look forward to.
Who's giving me?
Drove him to the mat on that slam.
Drove him right down into the canvas.
Oh, again, they are so vicious.
Oh, they certainly are. Everyone buzzing about the special innovations at WrestleMania 10. First time ever in the history of the WWF that the title will be contested twice in the same day.
Oh, yes. Twice as nice. Two for the price of one. It's a win-win situation for all the fans that will join us at WrestleMania 10.
Double swing shot. Well executed. They are devastating. Of course, the Made in America, Lex Luger, gets first crack at the reigning WWF champion. I'm assuming it's going to be Yokozuna, and then waiting in the wings. Well, not really waiting in the wings, because he's got one heck of assignment looking him square in the kisser. Bret the Hitman Hart will face the winner.
And speaking of square the kisser, look at here.
Uh-oh.
He's climbing up top. We know what this means. It's a...
The Samoan flop got him. It's all over.
And I'm sure Tony Roy and Scott Taylor are glad that it is over.
Referee hovering over there, making sure that no further damage is done as Offa is claiming the praises and looking for the accolades that his team really deserves.
Check out this. Oh, my goodness. I've never seen anybody shut up that high before. And there's that Samoan splash. No one has ever kicked out of the Samoan splash. All over.
Absolutely not, as we take another look at Nikolai. Plenty more action still to come. WrestleMania report coming up.
Todd Pettengill with your WrestleMania report exclusively for you guys on WWF Wrestling Challenge. I am extremely excited to report that just moments ago, Bastion Booger came out of his hole and saw his shadow. That means we are officially just 2 weeks away from WrestleMania 10. It is totally live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden in New York City, Sunday afternoon, March the 20th. Remember, the only way to see the action is on pay-per-view. It's a good idea to make that call now, because the longer you wait, the tougher it's going to be to get through to your local cable company. Of course, I can't make the call for you. I mean, I would if I could, but I can't. So let your fingers do the walking and your mouth do the talking. Get on the horn and make that call. We have assembled the greatest names in showbiz to entertain at WrestleMania. If these folks were on the stage in Vegas, you could expect to pay $400, $500, maybe $600 a ticket. And you'd probably be sitting behind some guy with a huge hat so you couldn't see anyway. We've got Jenny Garth, who plays Kelly on Beverly Hills 90210. We've got Showtime's Cabby Critics, Bucky and Vinny. Hey, we've got Cy Sperling. Remember, he's the official hair consultant for WrestleMania 10. Also scheduled to appear, rock superstar Donnie Wahlberg from NKOTB, the one and only Little Richard doing America the Beautiful, and the star of movies such as Deliverance, The Longest Yard, Smokey and the Bandit, Evening Shades, Burt Reynolds. All these celebrities will be part of the glitz, part of the glamour that is WrestleMania. But along with the stars and the bright lights, you get the greatest and without question the most historic wrestling matches of all time. Let's run that awesome card of action. Two WWF Championship matches are scheduled. Lex Luger wins the coin toss, of course. That means he earns the right to take on WWF Champion Yokozuna first. That, in turn, would mean Bret Hart would obviously have to have a match under his belt as well. He will take on his own brother, the Rocket Owen Hart. Then, regardless of the outcome of that match, the Bret and Owen match, the Hitman takes on the winner of the Lex-Yoko match. Now, keep in mind, there will also be two very special unannounced guest referees, one for each WWF Championship match, and as you know, they could be absolutely anyone. Now, let's move to a match the entire world is waiting to see. The Macho Man Randy Savage will meet Kona Crush head-on. Now, in this match, falls can occur anywhere in the building. The only catch is, in order to be declared the winner, you have to make it back to the ring in 60 seconds. These two WWF superstars were once the best of friends. Now, they want nothing to do with each other. The Intercontinental Championship also on the line as the bad guy, Razor Ramon, defends against the self-proclaimed Intercontinental Champ, Shawn Michaels. And this will be a ladder match. Now, here's how it works. Razor's Intercontinental Championship belt, along with Shawn Michaels' bogus belt, will be suspended high above the ring. Now, the 8-foot steel ladder starts in the aisle, and either Razor Ramon or Shawn Michaels can get the ladder at any time. The object is to put the ladder in the ring, climb up, and grab both belts. The superstar who can do that will be the Intercontinental Champion. Remember, once the ladder is in the ring, it is in play. Now, last week on WWF Superstars, our own Ray Hey Hey Rougeau caught up with the Heartbreak Kid.
And I climbed the ladder of the World Wrestling Federation to sit on top as the man, the top dog, the big man on campus. And Shawn Michaels is going to continue to sit on top of the World Wrestling Federation. Razor Ramon at WrestleMania 10, when everything is said and done, we'll be standing tall.
Yo, boy toy,
only 2 weeks away. The big one, man. WrestleMania 10. Feeling ready? The bad guy is ready. Hey, Chico, it's gonna be you, your gold, me, my gold, and a ladder. Come on.
Well, another title on the line is the Tag Team Championship. Men on a Mission try and take the belts away from the Quebecers. This match should be a classic as Mom seems hungry for a title. The WWF Women's Championship also on the line as champion Alundra Blaze defends her title. Plus, the mighty Earthquake will take on the man from Three Mile Island, the awesome Adam Bomb. In a mysterious mixed tag, Bam Bam Bigelow and his main squeeze, Luna Vachon, will take on Doink and Dink. Now, I should have asked for a new Dink for Christmas. I've got an old one, but it doesn't seem to work as well as it used to. You will also see a 10-man tag as the Smoking Guns team with the Native American superstar Tatanka, the 1-2-3 Kid, and Thurman Sparky Plug to do battle with the Head Shrinkers, IRS, Double J Jeff Jarrett, and the model Rick Martel. This is, without question, the biggest weekend of the year in the World Wrestling Federation, and I'm inviting you to be part of it. All you have to do is pick up that telephone, call your local cable company, and place your order for WrestleMania 10. We are now just 2 weeks away. 2 weeks from this Sunday, March the 20th, from the sold-out Madison Square Garden in New York City. Please, don't be the only person in your neighborhood to miss this one. Pick up the phone and make that call.
Three men on a collision course with destiny at WrestleMania 10. But before their historic showdown, each must first survive the grueling march to WrestleMania. Yokozuna wages war with the Native American Tatanka. Lex Luger goes head-on with Jimmy Del Rey. Bret Hart battles the Massive Crush. The WWF March to WrestleMania 10. A two-hour special, Sunday, March 13th.
Get the big red pencil, mark the date down on your calendar, Monday night, March 21st, Mid-Hudson Civic Center, Poughkeepsie, New York. Two big title matches. Yokozuna takes on Earthquake, and Razor Ramon takes on Ludwig Borga. Look out, here comes the Smoking Guns. They're involved in that big 10-man tag team matchup. Their partners, the Native American Tatanka, the 1-2-3 Kid, and your pal Sparky. Warm them up.
Rev it up, baby, now. The Smoking Guns, they are fired up. They're letting out those Texas war hoops. Those woo!
Well, I guarantee you, Stan, it won't be any picnic for them in Madison Square Garden. They'll be facing the Head Shrinkers, Double J, Erwin R. Scheister, and the model Rick Martel.
Oh, that's just one of the fantastic matches lined up for the biggest pay-per-view extravaganza of all time.
Boy, just take a look at that list, Dan, and you know where the experience lies.
Oh, yes, for sure. This does war whoops. I kind of like that. It kind of fires you up, kind of ramps you up, if you will.
Get them going, indeed. They'll all be headed towards Madison Square Garden, or sitting in front of their television and watching in the comfort of their living room as WrestleMania 10 unfolds and sets all kinds of precedents. First time ever, the title will be defended not once, but twice in the same day.
Yes! Billy Gunn caught him with a high hip toss. Deep arm drag, takes him over.
And what do we got? Another 5,000 seats in the Paramount stand.
Well, they are going fast. It's a hot item in the Big Apple. But what about the Fan Fest? That's what I'm looking forward to. An entire weekend of WrestleMania party-type action.
All the superstars in the World Wrestling Federation will be on hand. A chance for you to get up close and personal. And I understand you can also get a replica or a similarity of your picture on the cover of the WWF magazine.
No way. Is that right?
I thought I heard that.
Well, maybe you did. I'll tell you what else I can do. Goodness, he drove him down hard. They can sit a face-to-face set. They can visit the funeral parlor. Oh, it's going to be unbelievable.
And get the Doinkster in the dunk tank?
Yes. Look at this vertical suplex.
Boy, held it up there a long time.
Oh, textbook perfection.
Boy, have these guys come a long way since their inception here in the World Wrestling Federation. Across the throat.
They'll be there at the Fan Fest too, Gorilla.
I'm sure they will, along with a whole host of stars.
I want everybody to bring their cameras and bring plenty of film.
A chance to get up close and personal. I don't know too many guys want to get up close and personal with this pair.
Well, they are just tagging in and out, keeping the fresh man in the ring at all times. Quite impressive.
You've got to have that continuity if you want to be successful in tag team wrestling, and they're certainly doing that. Going to work now on the left arm and shoulder. Look at that. That's brute strength. There's no leverage involved there.
Whoa, that's a brute kick. Look at this. Horses him right up here.
Uh-oh.
We know what this means, Gorilla.
He's in the land of no return.
This could be the big revolver coming up. Oh, yeah.
Well, folks, plenty more still to come when we come back. A special feature of the awesome WWF champion, Yokozuna.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Jim. Jim.
G.I. Joe Battle Corps, all new action warriors, super long range firepower, secret bios, super posability, bad attitude. Battle Corps figures each sold separately. Oh, with a Joe.
G.I. Joe!
Bart had a cow, man, but he traded it for magic beans in the all new Bart and the Beanstalk for Game Boy from Acclaim.
Sunday, March 20th, will be the 10-year anniversary of WrestleMania. It will also be the one-year anniversary of the massive Yokozuna winning the World Wrestling Federation Championship. There is no question that in just one short year, Yokozuna has proven himself to be one of the most awesome WWF champions of all time. In defending his title, he has devastated the elite of the World Wrestling Federation. Just take a look at the list of WWF superstars he has defeated and knocked out of action in the past year. For instance, he Banzai Splashed the incredible Hitman Bret Hart. He defeated the once extraordinary Hulk Hogan. He knocked the Native American Tatanka out of action. He even squashed the legendary Macho Man Randy Savage. Since WrestleMania, there is no doubt the mammoth Yokozuna has left a succession of men at his feet. He is even responsible for the mysterious disappearance of The Undertaker. And now, the burning question on everyone's mind is, can anyone stop this destructive champion? The answer is, well, maybe, because one man looms on the horizon. Yes, that one man is made in the USA, Lex Luger. And in 2 weeks, he gets the first shot at the awesome WWF champion at WrestleMania 10. Plans on this night because Wednesday night, March 23rd, you want to be in the Westchester County Civic Center, White Plains, New York. Listen to these matchups. 600-pound Yokozuna taking on 500-pound Mabel, a man out of inches, and Lex Luger takes on the big guy from Kona, Crush. Take a look at the pearly whites on Sparky Plug.
With Sparky Plug, you know, he has a dual career, Gorilla. He motivates around that big oval about 190 miles an hour down in Talladega, Alabama. And then he comes here and takes on the World Wrestling Federation superstars.
Boy, that's kind of living on the edge, isn't it, Stan?
Oh,
turning the pages too quick for this old Gorilla, I'll tell you that.
He is definitely a thrill seeker.
Hey, if you want some thrills, how about it? Opening up this week, the WrestleMania Hotline. It's open right now.
Oh, yeah, and I'm going to be a part of that, Gorilla, you know.
Oh, I'm sure you are.
Daily interviews. I'm also going to have Stan Lane's exclusive behind-the-scenes updates from WrestleMania.
Well, it's going to be a classic, no question about that. Nice reversal and a hammerlock, and Sparky goes downstairs with a nice single leg trip. Whoa, scoops up. Very fire pluggish opponent and drops him like a bad
hammer. Well, he knows how to drive him down. He knows how to drive that stock car on the racetrack, too.
Look out. Sends him in for the ride, and whoa, Sparky, of course, part of that big 10-man tag team matchup at WrestleMania 10. His partners, the 1-2-3 Kid, Tatanka, and the Smoking Guns.
Yeah, we just saw Billy and Bart, and they're revved up for action, too. It's going to be the greatest WrestleMania of all time. No doubt about it.
Not only will the WWF Championship be contested twice, every other title in the World Wrestling Federation is up for grabs.
Whoa! High, high backdrop.
The tag belts currently held by the Quebecers as they will face Men on a Mission, where they could very easily kiss those belts goodbye.
Yeah, wouldn't little Johnny Polo hate that?
And how about the ladder match for the Intercontinental Championship between Razor Ramon and former Intercontinental Champion Shawn Michaels?
Oh, snap suplex. And don't forget about the 7-foot-tall, awesome Diesel at ringside.
And the very lovely Alundra Blaze,
WWF's
ladies champion, will defend her belt as well.
Sparky Plug just caught Centeno right in the chops.
He scoops him up. Whoa.
He softened him up. You know, this could be it, Gorilla. This could be the pit stop plunge.
Oh, he's way up there. Top turnbuckle.
That's it.
Oh, he got him.
Oh, yes.
Holy mackerel.
Wow, I like that. That's the pit stop plunge.
Pit stop indeed.
Victorious once again here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Boy, they certainly like him. What a hot item he is. Well, latest edition of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, available on newsstands everywhere this Tuesday. On the cover, Lex, the Hitman, and the Champ Yoko. But inside, a very interesting personality profile of Sparky Plug.
Vinny.
What?
How's your mom?
Oh, my mom's pretty good.
Yeah?
You know WrestleMania has a mom.
Is that right?
Yeah, they got this, tag team there.
Yeah.
One guy's name is Mitchell.
Boom! Ostrich.
That's the other guy.
Yeah.
Ostrich. And the third guy, his name is Mabel. Would you
Mabel.
Believe that?
Mabel! That's the giant guy. The big guy.
Big guy. Wow. This guy.
Killer.
Do you understand now how they got the name Mom?
Yeah.
M-O-M. Right? You got that, right?
Yeah, I got it.
Pretty
thanks.
Good. See?
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Face to Face. I'm Stan Lane. Fans, WrestleMania 10 has sold out. Slap out. You can still be a part of it. Oh, yes, you can. Join us in the Paramount for the telecast of WrestleMania 10 on giant screen closed circuit television. Call 212-307-7171 to order your tickets and be a part of all the excitement. If you're unable to join us in the garden, don't fret. All you have to do is pick up your phone and call your local cable company and order WrestleMania 10 exclusively on pay-per-view. And what an event it's going to be. 10 years in the making. The greatest sports event of all time and the granddaddy of all pay-per-views. Yes, WrestleMania is what started pay-per-views. And this is WrestleMania 10, 10 years after. You got to be there for this. Let's talk about some of the exciting matches already signed. Think about this. M-O-M, Men on a Mission, Mo and Mabel, in a tag team confrontation for the gold against the tag team champion Quebecers with Johnny Polo. And then what about this? The undisputed Intercontinental Champion Razor Ramon, the bad guy, takes on Shawn Michaels in a ladder rules match. Earlier I talked to Shawn Michaels and I asked him, how will you use the ladder to your advantage in this match?
Well, once again, for all you simpletons, Stan, Shawn Michaels is going to go over the rules again. Now, you have to beat your opponent down. The ladder is sitting in the aisle. You have to beat your opponent down, retrieve the ladder, and bring it in the ring. Now, how does the ladder come into play? Now, you can simply set it up, climb to the top and grab the belt, or, if you choose to do so, you can fold that ladder back up and beat your opponent senseless. Razor Ramon, which one do you think the Heartbreak Kid is going to do first? I guarantee you something. I'm going to pound you down, and then I'm going to set that ladder up and climb to glory. Climb the ladder of the World Wrestling Federation to what is rightfully mine, the Intercontinental Championship belt.
Wow, this could be wild and woolly right there in the garden. I also asked the bad guy, the undisputed champion, how he will use the ladder to his advantage.
The way I see it, for too long, been two belts, two champions. Shawn Michaels says he's a champ. I say I am. WrestleMania 10, ladder match. Both belts high above the ring. Steel ladder down the aisle. All you gotta do, beat your opponent up, scamper up the ladder, grab the gold. Other big problema, Big Daddy Cool, Ol Chico, and MSG gonna be a few bad guys watching me.
All that and so much more at WrestleMania 10, Sunday afternoon, March 20th, in the Garden. Pick up your phone right now, call your local cable company, and join us exclusively on pay-per-view.
Scene action.
Reigning Intercontinental Champion Razor Ramon.
Also scheduled the Macho Man Randy Savage.
And get this, a special interview with Bret the Hitman Hart and Lex Luger. For Stan, this is the Gorilla saying so long, everybody.